Hey guys, thanks for watching. I'm Soumya and I'm back with another recommendation video. I am going to be recommending 10 short stories collection to you guys. If you are a book lover and a reader, you should definitely hit subscribe to my channel Soumya's Book Station, as on this channel I make loads of bookish content. And if you like this video, do not forget to give this a thumbs up and also share it. And also do press the bell icon so that every time I post a video, you get notified. So finally, monsoon has arrived in Delhi and I am so thankful for that, because Delhi weather was getting unbearable because of the heat. And also I kind of went on a short break from YouTube, which was a forced one because my schedule got really busy, but now I'm back. Which city are you from and what kind of weather is going on in your city? Let me know in the comments. So I had made a recommendation video for short stories collection in 2018 as well. If you want to check that one out for more recommendations of short stories, in case you love reading short story collections, I'll leave the link for that in the description. Let's get on with this one. My first recommendation is If You See Me, Don't Say Hi by Neil Patel. So this is a collection of 11 short stories about Indian immigrants living in the United States. So this book contains a lot of human experiences in its stories. We read about longing, we read about unrequited love, we read about betrayal. And so the stories have covered a lot of human relationships. And these are 11 short stories that get over in no time, but they leave you with a lot of experiences. All the stories in this book have a distinct quality of their own. The next one is Bombay Stories by Saadat Hasan Manto, translated by Matt Reek and Aftab Ahmed. This is a collection of 14 short stories that take us through the Bombay of 1930s, through the lives of characters like prostitutes, pimps, crooks and thugs and people like that. This book does not show the glamorous side of Mumbai, but a darker and the dirtier side of the city through these characters that belong to the low-life section of the society. Many things make this an outstanding read. One of them is that Manto introduces the reader to a world that the reader is probably not familiar with, a completely different world residing in the dark recesses of Bombay. And the way he does that, it feels like while reading, you are present right there. The picturization in this book is that strong. Another thing is that you connect with the characters in this book on an emotional level, because even though they belong to a completely different world, a world that makes them seem like faraway creatures, they are still human beings, they still have human emotions, and the kind of emotions they go through, you go through. And when you read them going through those emotions, you feel a human connection with them. The next one is Bombay Brides by Esther David. So this is a collection of stories about Indian Jews living in the fictitious Shalom India Housing Society in Ahmedabad. So all the short stories in this book are either about the characters living in this society or people who are connected to the characters living in the Shalom India Housing Society. So all these stories are detached and separate in their own ways, but still this book gives a vibe of a novel, because at the end of the day, you know while reading that these characters are familiar with each other. When I picked it up, it was the first time that I found out that India had a Jewish community of its own, and while reading this book in its short stories, I kept coming across the customs and traditions that Jewish people follow, so I learned something new. That was very fascinating. I love that about this book. And the second thing about this book that I absolutely loved is that the stories are very simple, and it makes this book a very breezy kind of a read, because the stories have a very, very comfortable and a very lovely predictability about them that you do not resent at all, that you enjoy in fact. Reading Bombay Brides is like you enter a new world, but you discover that there are quite a few similarities that exist in this world and you are able to relate to them. The stories in this book are based on topics like marriage, love, familial relationships. The next one is Norse Mythology by Neil Gaiman. So this is a collection of stories which are basically the retellings of Norse myths, Neil Gaiman's interpretation of Norse myths, and these stories are taking place in Asgard, which is the home of gods. And we read about different creatures from the world like giants and dwarves, and we read about different kinds of gods like Loki and Thor and other gods. So if you are into retellings and mythology, and if you haven't read this book, you should definitely go for it, because these stories are very interesting and entertaining and gripping. This is one of those books that when you pick it up, you are not able to put it down, because the stories are very interesting. The next one is Chicken Soup for the Indian Bride's Soul. So this is a collection of stories about Indian weddings contributed by Indian women. This book contains all kinds of stories related to marriage and wedding, love stories leading up to the marriage, the wedding jitters faced by different women, and the stories shared by girls who were newlyweds. You know, they shared their experiences, how it was after they got married. In case you do not know how Chicken Soup books work, basically a lot of people often send in their own experiences, real experiences, and they kind of make a compilation out of that and a book is formed. Some of the stories are obviously written by proper authors and writers, but a lot of them are written by common people. This book has a very Indian feel. While reading certain stories, you feel that you are actually talking to that very person who's going to get married. The kind of experiences a lot of these women have shared are the same experiences that you hear from the women you know in your life who are going to get married or who have recently got married. So in that regard, this is a very relatable book, and because of that, while reading it, it becomes very close to your heart. The next one is Collected Stories by Rabindranath Tagore. So this is a collection of 10 stories, and when I picked this book up for the first time, what caught my attention was that it had the story Kabuliwala, a story that I really love and I associated with my childhood, because that's when I had read it the first time in Hindi. The first time I had read Kabuliwala, it had made me cry, and when I read it again in English, it was no different. I cried again, because that's how that story is. Remaining 9 stories are also very, very effective and make you emotional. You read about misfortunes and human suffering of characters in those stories, and they have been written very well. These are the stories that when you read them, they're so emotional that they straight away shoot an arrow to your heart, and because of that, you become very attached to them. The next one is Mortal Dawn by Saadat Hasan Manto. Again, this one has been translated from Urdu by Khalid Hasan. This book consists of 50 sketches and stories from the time of partition. Now, this book is supposed to be fiction, but when you read these stories, you realize that these stories are fiction only in the name, because they are definitely inspired from true events. So when you read this book, you realize how Manto has captured the trauma that people went through during the time of partition of India. It was a mass exodus that caused a lot of human tragedy. Many lives were lost, and the worst side of humanity came to the fore during that time. This book has all kinds of stories that are going to haunt you, that you will not be able to forget. When you read these stories, one part of your brain finds this book unputdownable and you want to keep going, but another part of your brain is not able to take the trauma that comes with reading these stories. The next one is Poos Ki Raat and Anya Kahaniya by Munshi Premchand. As you can see, this is a collection of stories in Hindi. मैंने ये अभी recently ही book पढ़ी है. मुझे मुंशी प्रेमचंद की कहानियाँ पढ़ना बहुत पसंद है, और उसके काफ़ी सारे reasons हैं. पहला तो ये reason है कि उनकी stories बहुत ज़्यादा interesting और gripping होती हैं, जैसा कि आप जानते ही हैं. और secondly, उनकी जो भाषा शैली है वो बोलचाल की भाषा होती है, simple हिंदी और उर्दू होती है, तो उसे समझना काफ़ी ज़्यादा easy होता है. ज़िंदगी के हर aspect के बारे में उन्होंने कहानियाँ लिखी है. इस short story collection को पढ़ते समय मुझे ऐसा एहसास हुआ कि प्रेमचंद ने जो खुद जिया है उसी पर ही कहानियाँ लिखी हैं. और दूसरी एक बात है जो इस बुक में मैंने महसूस करी, कि हर स्टोरी के एंड में एक मॉरल लेसन था. आई वेंट बैक इन टाइम बिकॉज ऑफ दीज स्टोरीज. इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू गेट योर हैंड्स ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर कलेक्शन ऑफ स्टोरीज, यू कैन गो फॉर एनी अदर कलेक्शन ऑफ स्टोरीज बाय मुंशी प्रेमचंद, बिकॉज ऑल ऑफ हिज स्टोरीज हैव अ मैजिक ऑफ देयर ओन. एंड इन केस यू डोंट नो हाउ टू रीड हिंदी, दैट वोंट बी अ प्रॉब्लम, बिकॉज हिज बुक्स आर इजिली अवेलेबल इन इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन एज वेल. The next one is All Roads Lead to Ganga by Ruskin Bond. So this is kind of a travel memoir, a very short one actually. It's non-fiction, but it's still like a collection of stories, because in this book, in different chapters, Ruskin Bond has shared his different experiences of traveling around Uttarakhand, and that is why I love this book. Especially if you are from a city that has a bustling, busy life, you will be able to appreciate this book all the more, because through his visual writing and through his lovable descriptions of Uttarakhand, Ruskin Bond takes you to Uttarakhand through this book. You make a journey of your own in your mind. If you are somebody who loves to read about mountains and nature, then this is a book that you should definitely go for. And my final recommendation is Blind Willow Sleeping Woman by Haruki Murakami. I, for my part, loved most of the stories in this book. I'm not an ardent fan of Murakami, neither am I a hater. I'm somewhere in the middle of that spectrum. But for me, this book was a good experience. It did its job in detaching me from the reality, something that you expect a Murakami book to do. I think this book did that job perfectly well. I do not recommend this book to each and every reader. That is why I saved it for the last. There are two kinds of people that can read and enjoy Blind Willow Sleeping Woman by Murakami. One of them has to be an ardent Murakami fan, because if you are an ardent Murakami fan, you already love his writing style, and this book is his writing style in all its quirkiness and surreal quality. And the second kind of people are those who are looking to read an experimental read, who are looking to read something completely different and don't mind reading stories that might underwhelm them at some point, stories that might not wow them exactly but will still keep them engaged. If you fall in either of these two categories, you can go for this one. So we have reached the end of the video. These are my 10 recommendation of short story collections for you guys. Do go ahead and pick them up, and I hope you enjoy these books as much as I did. And if you want to get your hands on any of these wonderful books, then it would be great if you could use my Amazon link in the description box, as it helps me, supports me. Thank you for watching this video. Do not forget to leave your own recommendations in the comments. If you want to connect with me on my social media, the links are in the description. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye.